Finally, the official cast of James Gunn's new DC movie The Suicide Squad has been decided. The director confirmed this a few days ago via Twitter and completes, at least in terms of the cast, his mini-reboot of the first Suicide Squad part from 2016. There will be a reunion with Jay Courtney as Captain Boomerang, Joel Kinnaman as Rick Flagg, Viola Davis as Amanda Waller, and of course Margot Robbie as Harley Quinn. Also, the new Task Force characters Peacemaker, Polka Dot Man, Ratcatcher and King Shark have been announced. So far so good, but Gunn now contributes with another tweet, confusion, as he expresses that although he confirms the named actors, their roles are not set yet. Other additions include Idris Elba, Storm Reid, Nathan Fillion, Taika Waititi, Peter Capaldi, Sean Gunn, Michael Rooker and many more. When everything is working out as planned, The Suicide Squad is scheduled to go into production this year, with the cinema release expected in August 2021. Is Robert Downey Jr. really returning as Iron Man? At least that's what the magazine Deadline believes to know, referring to the writer Geoff Butcher, who announced that Downey Jr. would take on the role of Tony Stark again in the new Black Widow film. This comes as a surprise, as most fans had more or less said goodbye to Iron Man after the epic finale of Avengers Endgame. But since Black Widow will take place after Captain America Civil War, it's not at all unlikely that Stark would turn up as he is still alive there. At least there would be many advantages if Downey Jr. could be seen in the role of Iron Man again. On the one hand, you will make many fans happy. On the other hand, you can technically build a bridge from Phase 3 to Phase 4 with this story. After all, Downey Jr. is the linchpin of the last MCU movies. Whether he will show up at the end of the day, we can't say for sure yet. But those who will definitely be part of the cast are behind the camera the director Kate Shortland, as well as the actors Florence Pugh, Rachel Weisz and David Harbour. Andy Park, the visual director of Marvel, also published a small artwork of the upcoming film on his Twitter channel. Black Widow will be released in cinemas on 1st of May 2020. A few months ago, the Game of Thrones saga came to an end with its final 8th season. Now Game of Thrones creator George R.R. Martin comments on the future of the franchise in form of a spin-off about the Targaryens. In contrast to the other unnamed prequel, whose first episodes have already been filmed, the planning of the Targaryen spin-off is still in its beginning. On Martin's website, not a blog, he not only announces his thoughts on the upcoming series, but also confirms the work on it with the following statement. The pilot on that one wrapped a month ago and has been in post-production. The show stirring up all the internet headlines right now is one of the others. Also a prequel. Set thousands of years after Jane's show in the history of Westeros. And yes, it is based on material from one of my books. The book mentioned is of course Fire and Blood, which story takes place around 300 years before the events in Game of Thrones. Martin also adds that his book offers a base for dozens of series. However, the production hasn't moved much forward yet, as at the moment only the script for the pilot episode is roughly finished. The author, who turned 71 a few days ago, raises hope for fans who are looking for more Game of Thrones spin-offs, as he plans to produce more of them. Unfortunately, there is currently no release date for either of the two spin-offs. Already from 11th of October 2019 you can stream the new Breaking Bad film El Camino on Netflix. Aaron Paul, who was one of the main actors of the series, but also the supporting character Badger, played by Matt Jones, will be part of it. Many of you might have remembered him from the series, since the actions of the foolish little criminal will surely have caused some Breaking Bad fans to get frustrated. In addition, the character of Skinny Pete, who was shown in an interrogation scene in the trailer, will also return. The big question, of course, is whether Walter White will be seen again, even though he didn't leave the last episode of the series alive. A few appearances and flashbacks are quite possible, though not 100% certain. We assume that we will get to see another trailer before the release on October 11th anyway, which will perhaps answer some unsettled questions. Although It Chapter 2 is still running in the cinemas at the moment, director Andy Muschietti is already a few steps ahead again. Alongside the work on Stephen King's novel Roadwork that was announced a few weeks ago, he's now working with his sister on the next project, in fact Stephen King's story The Jaunt. In an interview with Consequence of Sound he comments, "It's tough to crack because it's such a great short story, then you have to expand it into a great film narrative. It took a while, but now I think we got it. I don't want to tell too much." Furthermore, he adds that the film adaption has been in the planning stages for several years, but finally became more concrete as an author had finally been found. However, he didn't want to reveal the name yet. The story of The Jaunt revolves around an invention for teleporting. The whole thing then expands so far that one can not only travel across the entire planet in a few seconds, but also everywhere in space. The key to this is that the traveler has to sleep during the process. If he doesn't, the teleportation feels like many years for the traveler instead of a fraction of a second. In the center of the story is family Oates, who are about to travel to Mars in 2307. As you can imagine, it doesn't turn out so fine for everyone involved. Further information about cast, producers, or other details are unfortunately not yet available. The next Stephen King adaptation is already waiting for us on November 21st, 2019, as The Shining sequel Dr. Sleep will be released in the cinemas.